Do we honor the Lord in the way we treat our neighbor? A blessed Saturday, brothers and sisters. This is our reflection question for today.
Holy Spirit, make my heart open to the Word of God. Make my heart open to goodness. Make my heart open to the beauty of God every day. Amen.
Born in the 3rd century in Anise, Burgundy, France, Saint Regina was the daughter of Clement, a pagan aristocrat. When her mother died at birth, she was entrusted to a Christian nurse who secretly baptized her. When her father learned this, he repudiated Regina and drove her away from her family's home. She lived as a poor, prayerful shepherdess together with her Christian nurse. She worked in the fields daily, tending sheep to help support the household. In the fields, Regina grew closer to the Lord, meditating and contemplating His love and mercy. She also prayed to emulate the lives of the holy saints and martyrs. In 251, at the age of 15, she caught the eye of Librius, the prefect of Gaul, who became determined to have her as his wife. He sent for her and discovered she was of a noble race with a strong Christian faith. He attempted to have her deny her faith, but Saint Regina refused. Angered by this, he resorted to whippings, scorching, burning pincers, and iron combs. But Saint Regina did not give in. The grace of God further sustained her, as she continued to praise God and defy Olybrius. In the end, she was beheaded, ending her life and the conversion of many witnesses present who observed a solitary dove hovering atop her head during her torture. Saint Regina is the patron saint of torture victims, poor people, and shepherdess. While he was going through a field of grain on a Sabbath, his disciples were picking the heads of grain, rubbing them in their hands, and eating them. Some Pharisees said, "Why are you doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath?" Jesus said to them in reply, "Have you not read what David did when he and those who were with him were hungry? How he went into the house of God, took the bread of offering, which only the priests could lawfully eat, ate of it, and shared it with his companions. Then he said to them, 'The Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath.'" The Catechism of the Catholic Church says, "The Gospel reports many incidents when Jesus was accused of violating the Sabbath law. But Jesus never fails to respect the holiness of this day. He gives this law its authentic and authoritative interpretations. The Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath." With compassion, Jesus declared the Sabbath for doing good rather than harm, for saving life rather than killing. The Sabbath is the day of the Lord of mercies, and a day to honor God. The Son of Man is Lord, even of the Sabbath. In the Scriptures, Jesus argues that human need takes precedence over ritual custom. In today's Gospel reading, the Pharisees says so much about the state of their hearts by saying so little. "Why are you doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath?" The Pharisees are all focused on external details of the law and fail to perceive the big picture that Christ came to bring, complete love for God and selfless love for one's neighbor. As followers of Christ, we are called to have an unconditionally loving heart rather than one that weighs cost. Another character in this passage is King David. Christ praises his decision to feed his starving army rather than adhering to some norms of the law regarding eating. Through time and paces, David developed a remarkable heart that loved God and his neighbor. The heart of Christ showed so much love to the apostles in this passage. Christ's heart was so immersed with love for this man, who would be the pillars of the church, and who would bring his message to the whole world. How far his thoughts were from the littleness and pettiness of the empty prescriptions of the law. His law is the new law of love. Behold the heart that has so loved men. Christ sees us as friends, called to love the church, and as apostles sent to spread the gospel to the ends of the world, just as he saw his fellow apostles in the film. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, may we honor you in our service and in our rest. Allow us to treat our neighbors with respect and kindness. Help us to be loving and compassionate to others, and to seek their good at all times. Jesus, King of Mercy, we trust in you. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers, and sisters. God bless our Catholic Church and Couples for Christ.